中文台嘅記者又有英文台嘅記者，所以咧，不如等阿婉太咧一陣咧，佢先講咗我哋即係今日想宣布嘅嘢，咁咧就中文同埋英文咧都會講一次，所以方便你哋啲新聞界嘅朋友有啲 clips 啊咁樣。咁之後我哋睇一睇個時間點，睇下咧阿婉太能夠盡量答到幾多問題，因為今日時間有啲緊迫。咁或者我哋請阿婉太先講一講我哋有咩宣布先
啦。好，各位新聞界嘅朋友，唔好意思要你哋等嚇，咁啊。放假都冇得放假，好似我一樣係嘛？好嗱，咁咧就同大家宣布一下，中電咧已經同政府落實咗2012年嘅電費調整嘅方案，明年嘅電費咧將會係98.7仙，升幅咧係4.9%。咁呢一個有關新嘅電價嘅方案咧，大家將會喺你嗰個新聞嗰個資料上咧就會有詳細嘅資料噶啦。這個新的方案呢比在我們在12月13日公布的 9.2% 的升幅呢是調低了的，主要呢是因為我們採取了以下的措施，包括呢我們剔除了預算投放在新增發電容量的資本開支，還有呢我們是進一步呢削減我們的營運成本，我們亦都將我們的電費調整穩定的基金水平進一步調低，還有呢我們會提供一個地租差餉的特別回扣。我就會將上述的措施向大家逐一個解釋的。首先是有關這個基本的電價，基本的電價呢的升幅呢是會由我們兩個星期前宣布的5仙下調到4.2仙，主要咧係因為咧，我哋係剔除咗預算投放喺新增發電容量嘅資本開支，以及咧我哋再進一步咧調低咗我哋嘅營運成本。另外咧我哋係調低電費嘅穩定基金水平至到咧係1億港元，令到我哋咧可以舒緩電價對客户嘅影響。而呢一個1億元嘅水平咧，係我哋中電以嚟咧歷來最低嘅。亦都只是相等於我們中電一日的售電收入而已。關於那個地租和差餉的特別回扣，就中電向差餉物業估價處追討，在過去十幾年我們認為他們多收我們的地租和差餉，我們曾經向大眾承諾過，一旦法庭作出了最終的裁判，令到中電可以收回任何的退款，我們將會將這些退款呢全數是向我們的客戶呢提供特別的回扣。這個個案呢其實仍然還在法庭的審議階段，還未曾是完結。我們呢就是跟我們的律師呢再次評估事情的新發展啦，令到我們呢增加信心呢可以在政府那裡呢最終呢是可以收到有關的退款。所以我們現在就向我們的客戶提供每一度電3.3仙的特別回扣，藉此是抵消部分電價的升幅的。有關這個燃料價格條款的收費，大家都知道全球的燃料價格波幅很大，而且是明顯有上升的趨勢。香港和世界很多地方都一樣，我們是要採用更加多的乾淨的能源，尤其是要多用天然氣。中電和政府其實都是同樣面對一個挑戰，就是我們需要以用更高燃料價格和更多的天然氣來發電，要符合政府向我們電廠日益收緊的排放的上限。中電的燃料價格條款帳其實已經累積了負結餘多年了，即是說現在我們的電價是沒有完全反映了我們的燃料成本，所以我們是需要採取一些審慎的措施，將每一度電的燃料價格條款收費增加 3.7 仙，以舒緩燃料價格上升帶來的影響。我們也會繼續留意燃料價格、燃料市場的最新的情況咧，將睇下佢對我哋嘅電價會造成嘅咩影響。另外咧，由於咧社會上咧對於我哋打算向商業客户提出嘅電價結構改變嘅意見咧，有唔同嘅意見。我哋咧就將會延遲落實呢一個改動。其實我哋呢個電價嘅結構改變嘅建議咧， 係想鼓勵商户咧係節能嘅。我哋咧會喺未來嘅幾個月咧，同各方多啲嘅溝通，直至到咧我哋呢一個提議咧係得到更多嘅公眾人士支持咧，我哋先至落實。換句話嚟講咧，目前嘅商業客户咧，佢哋採用緊嘅電價結構咧係將會維持不變。新嘅電價修訂方案咧，既可以平衡政府嘅期望，亦都令到我哋可以咧維持中電一貫嘅卓越服務水平，繼續為我哋香港嘅客户咧提供優質嘅供電。另外咧，我哋係會繼續以嚴謹同埋審慎嘅理財原則去營運，向我哋嘅客户、政府同埋我哋嘅股東咧係負責嘅。中電咧係已經咧審慎研究各種咧可以降低電價升幅嘅方案。今次嘅最終修訂方案咧，係中電同政府咧經過多番嘅討論之後嘅成果。我哋相信呢一個方案係政府可以接受，亦都咧係已經咧回應咗政府提出嘅關注。自從我哋喺兩個星期前咧公開咗我哋嘅電價調整之後咧，期間咧曾經係作出咗回應，亦都咧提供過一啲新嘅補充資料。當中嘅過程裏面咧，可能令到我哋嘅客户咧感到好混淆，其實我哋係好唔好意思嘅。咁喺跟住呢幾日咧，我哋嘅同事咧係會喺就我哋今日公布呢個嘅最終電價方案咧，積極同我哋唔同嘅客户解釋詳情。Okay, good afternoon, friends. CLP has finalized with government a revised package for our electricity tariff for 2012. Our average tariff is going to be 98.7 cents, an increase of 4.9% from the current year. This represents a reduction from the proposed increase of 9.2% that we announced on December the 13th. The new package has significantly narrowed the increase from that announced earlier as a result of a number of measures, namely savings from the removal of planned capital expenditure on additional generating capacity and further efforts to reduce operating costs, a deeper drawdown on our tariff stabilization fund, and a rent and raise special rebate. I will explain these items one by one. On basic tariff,The increase of our basic tariff is now 4.2 cents, down from 5 cents announced 2 weeks ago. This is attributable to savings from the removal of planned capital expenditure on additional generating capacity and extra efforts in enhancing cost control measures on operation. In addition, drawing down the tariff stabilization fund to a projected level of $100 million also allows buffer to reduce the impact of tariff increase to our customers.This is the lowest balance ever recorded by CLP and represents just one day of electricity sales for CLP. On the rent and rates special rebate, CLP has made a commitment to return to our customers any repayments made by government upon the final resolution of the court in our favor in respect of CLP's claims against RVD's overcharging of our rent and rates over the past decade.While the case is still continuing and has not yet been finalized, we have discussed further with our lawyers of the latest development, which increases our confidence of finally getting a refund from government. Therefore, we have taken the initiative to provide a special rebate of 3.3 cents per unit to offset part of the tariff increase. On fuel cross charges, global fuel costs are moving at very high levels of increases,with high volatility, and Hong Kong is competing with many economies for cleaner fuels, in particular, more gas to generate electricity. The challenges that both CLP and government faces nowadays is the higher fuel costs and the increased usage of gas for generating electricity in order that we can meet the further tightening emission caps imposed on our power stations.CLP is already carrying a deficit fuel clause account on behalf of the customers for many years. As a result, it is a prudent measure to increase our fuel clause charge by 3.7 cents per unit to smooth out the impact of fuel cost in the coming years. CLP will continue to monitor the fuel market and its implications to our tariff carefully. In addition, as opinions on the tariff structure change for our commercial customers are divided. We will defer the implementation of this energy efficiency-driven initiative until a wider public acceptance is reached. The current tariff structure for commercial customers will therefore remain unchanged for the time being. The new package represents a balanced outcome that meets government's objectives without compromising the quality of service to our customers in Hong Kong. Our ability to exercise strict discipline for a prudent and long-term financial management on behalf of our customers and our shareholders can also be upheld. CLP has critically reviewed options to help reduce the tariff increase. The final package is a result of extensive discussions with government and has addressed their concerns. We believe government will find this package acceptable. Since our announcement of an earlier tariff package 2 weeks ago, we have made some responses and offered new information, some of which may have caused confusion to our customers. In the coming days, my colleagues will reach out to our customers to offer the details of this final package and answer any questions that they may have.
或者咁樣好唔好啊？我哋可唔可以有少少調整先？你哋如果有問題，麻煩你哋address下自己。咁我哋睇一睇個時間，我哋睇下盡量可以答到幾多得幾多。
不如一樣，佢哋問曬啲問題。
係啦，你一係咧就一次過問曬啲問題，我哋咧就話遠睇一次過答，咁可能又好啲。